In the previous video, we talked about process paths, so work being converted to heat and using devices called heat engines to convert heat back into work. We also know from our day-to-day interactions that heat is transferred in the direction of decreasing temperature. So if you have a hot cup of soup, it decreases in temperature until it's room temperature. This happens naturally, without us having to do anything. However, if we wanted to transfer more heat from our soup to below room temperature, we need special devices. In other words, to transfer heat from a low temperature medium to a high temperature medium requires devices called refrigerators. Imagine you're inside your room on a hot summer day, and the inside temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. It's too hot, so you turn on the air conditioner. What it's doing is absorbing the heat from the room air and discharging it to the outside. In simple terms, it's moving heat away from your room and taking it to another location. The key here is to understand that the outside temperature is usually higher than the room temperature. So it moves heat from a low temperature medium to a high temperature medium. Refrigerators, just like heat engines, work in a cycle. This is a basic vapor compression refrigeration cycle. The working fluid inside the refrigeration cycle is called a refrigerant. The refrigerant enters the compressor as a vapor and is compressed. Here, there is work input since energy is required for the compressor to function. After the refrigerant is compressed, it has a relatively high temperature and high pressure. It then enters the condenser and then condenses to a liquid as it flows through the coils of the condenser and cools down. Here, there is heat output since heat is rejected into the surroundings. It then enters the expansion valve and there is a large drop in pressure and temperature. Now it enters the evaporator where the refrigerant evaporates by absorbing the heat in the refrigerated space. In simple terms, heat is absorbed, which changes the refrigerant from a liquid to a vapor. Because heat is absorbed by the refrigerated area gets colder. It will then go back into the compressor as a vapor, and the cycle repeats. If we were to use high and low temperature environments, our diagram would look like this. So we would have a warm environment here, and QH represents the magnitude of heat rejected to the environment. On the bottom, we have the cold refrigerated space. QL represents the magnitude of heat removed from the refrigerated space. We also have the work input required by the compressor. Just to recap, this is what the schematic for a heat engine looked like from the previous video. The effectiveness of a refrigerator is expressed by something called the coefficient of performance, or COP with a subscript R to represent a refrigerator. Keep in mind that the function of a refrigerator is to remove heat from a refrigerated space. To do this, it needs work input. So if we wanted to figure out the COP, we need to divide the desired output by the required input. In this case, the desired output is QL and the required input is the work input. Again, QL is the magnitude of heat removed from the refrigerated space. Remember that for any cyclic device, we can find the work input by subtracting QL from QH. If we plug this into our COP equation, we can write it like this. Keep in mind that COP values can be greater than 1. In simple terms, the amount of heat removed from the refrigerated space can be greater than the amount of work input. So again, we're moving heat from one location to another, and to move that heat requires some energy. The key word being move. This is why COP values can be greater than 1, because a small amount of work can move a large amount of heat. Heat pumps are another device that can move heat from a low temperature medium to a high temperature medium. In fact, they operate on the same cycle, but does something a bit different. Remember that for a refrigerator, the goal is to move heat from the refrigerated area, so keeping it cool inside, while moving the heat outside. With a heat pump, the goal is to maintain a heated space. It does this by absorbing heat from a low temperature source, like the outside air in the winter, and then moving this heat into a high temperature space. A schematic for a heat pump would look like this. Here, we have the heated space on top. QH represents our desired output, which is the magnitude of heat transferred into the heated space. On the bottom, we have the cold environment, and QL represents the magnitude of heat transferred to the cycle. The compressor still requires work input as well. The only difference between a heat pump schematic and a refrigeration schematic is our desired output. For a refrigeration cycle, our desired output is QL, and for a heat pump, it's QH. The effectiveness of a heat pump is also expressed in terms of COP with the subscript HP. Again, it's the desired output divided by the required input. This time, the desired output is the magnitude of heat brought into the heated medium, so QH divided by the work input. Air conditioners are also just refrigerators. Instead of cooling a small space to keep your ice cream from melting, an air conditioner cools your whole house or a room to keep you comfortable. It absorbs heat from your room and moves it outside. Now let's go through some examples to see how we can apply what we learned. Let's take a look at this problem, where we have a food department kept at a low temperature by a refrigerator. We need to figure out the power input to the compressor and the COP of the refrigerator. Let's start by writing down what we know. The temperature of our cooled food department is negative 12 degrees Celsius. The environment has a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. The condenser rejects 4,800 kilojoules per hour to the environment, so that's our QH. The magnitude of heat removed from the space is 33,000 kilojoules per hour, which is our QL. Keep in mind that our QH and QL are given in rate form, so we have a dot on top. What we're looking for is this value here, which is the work input for our compressor. If we subtract QL from QH, we get our work input. Let's plug our values in. Since the question wants the answer in kilowatts, we need to use a conversion. Remember that 1 kilowatt is equal to 3,600 kilojoules per hour. To figure out the COP value, we need to divide QL by the work input, since this is a refrigerator. Our desired output is QL and required input is work input. We get a COP value of 2.2. Let's take a look at this question involving a house and an air conditioner. We need to figure out the power drawn by the said air conditioner on a summer day. Let's start off by writing down what we know. The initial temperature of the house is 35 degrees Celsius and drops to 20 degrees Celsius in 30 minutes. The COP of the air conditioner is 2.8. The mass of air inside the house is 800 kilograms, and we're given the constant volume and pressure-specific heats. We first need to figure out how much heat needs to be removed from the house, QL. So how do we do that? Well, we need to think back to the energy balance of closed systems. We first need to figure out the internal energy change of our system, which in this case is the house when the temperature drops. Then if we multiply it by the mass of air, we get the total amount of heat that needs to be removed from the house. If you need a refresh, please watch the video about internal energy. First, the internal energy. Note that the house is well sealed, which means it's a constant volume, so we can use the CV value for our calculation. The difference in temperature is just the subtraction of the initial temperature from the final temperature. Now that we found the internal energy, we just need to multiply it by the mass of air, and we get the total heat that needs to be removed. This tells us that 8,640 kilojoules of energy needs to be removed for the temperature to drop from 35 to 20 degrees Celsius. Since this drop in temperature happens in 30 minutes, we can figure out the rate of heat transfer. Don't forget to convert 30 minutes to seconds. This tells us that 4.8 kilojoules of heat was removed out every second, which is the same as 4.8 kilowatts. Now all we need to do is use our coefficient of performance equation to get the work input. Solving gives us the power drawn by the air conditioner. Let's take a look at this problem with a heat pump and we are asked to find the COP and the rate of heat absorption from the outside air. We can start by writing down what we know. The refrigerant enters the condenser at 800 kilopascals at a rate of 0.018 kilograms per second and a temperature of 35 degrees Celsius. It leaves the condenser with the same pressure but is now a saturated liquid. We're also told that the compressor uses 1.2 kilowatts of power. To find the COP of the heat pump, we can use this equation. To use it, we first need to figure out the heat rejected by the condenser. So how do we do that? With the given pressures and temperatures, we can figure out the enthalpies of the refrigerant. If we multiply the mass flow rate by the difference in enthalpy, we can get the heat transfer rate. Please see the video on energy transfer by mass if you need a refresh. So let's take a look at the pressure table for R134a. Looking at a pressure of 800 kilopascals, we see that the saturation temperature is only 31 degrees Celsius, which is lower than the temperature given to us. That means the refrigerant is a superheated vapor at this stage, so we need to look at the superheated vapor chart. So here is our pressure, but unfortunately, we're not given a value for 35 degrees Celsius. So we need to extrapolate to get a value. The easiest way is to plot two points, so we can use 31.3 and 40 degrees Celsius, along with their enthalpy values on a graph, and then figure out the enthalpy value for 35 degrees Celsius. You can also just figure out the equation for the graph using the two points as well. If you need extra details, please check the description where I show how to get the equation. Either way, you get a value of 271.2 kilojoules per kilogram. Now that we have the initial enthalpy, we need the enthalpy after the refrigerant leaves the condenser as a saturated liquid. So we look at the pressure table and look for the saturation liquid enthalpy value, which is right here. Let's plug these values into our equation. Remember that kilojoules per second is the same as kilowatts. Now we can go back to our COP equation and figure it out. The last part of the question wants us to figure out the rate of heat absorption from the outside air. For that, we can use this equation. Solving tells us that 1.96 kilowatts of heat is absorbed from the outside air. That should cover the types of problems you will face when it comes to refrigerators. Thanks for watching and best of luck with your studies.